I thought when I was a little kid, I wanted to be an astronaut. I remember as a Cub Scout, you had to make a scrapbook. And I made a scrapbook about the space program. And I wanted to be an astronaut. I was 8 years old. And by the time I was 12, I realized that nobody in the world ever gets to be an astronaut or president of the United States. And then lo and behold, as I'm coming out of medical school, the opportunity came to apply for astronaut, and I became an astronaut. Who would have thunk it?
Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Here I function in the federal service as an engineer, as an astronaut, as a physician, as a manager and leader. I've had all those jobs. I've been in the federal service in 5 different agencies. And it was seamless. There's not many places you could do that. Patient safety is a very important topic, and that's because everybody at one time or another has to encounter the medical system, whether it's for themselves personally, for their families. You know, and the fact is, more people die in the United States every year due to mistakes that happen in medicine, in their medical care, than die due to motor vehicle accidents, AIDS, cervical cancer, breast cancer in the whole year. 5 to 10% of everybody that enters a hospital ends up inadvertently injured. I mean, that's extraordinary. You know, and about 0.5% end up dying. Not because of their diagnosis, because of the way the care was delivered. The VA called me up and asked me to become involved, and I said, boy, this is something that I had recognized from when I first started medicine, that medicine didn't do well, and I was thrilled to have the opportunity to do it. Nobody wants to hurt a patient, so we gave them ways to not hurt patients in a really aggressive way and really put a lot of systems in place that have been translated both throughout the private sector in the United States as well as around the world, and they flock to it and do it, so it's been very rewarding. I am absolutely proud of what the National Center for Patient Safety has accomplished, and I'm especially proud of the people I work with. I feel it's the best job I've ever had in my life, most satisfying. And until somebody tells me this job's done, I'm going to keep doing it until they fire me, or we've declared success.